Do you know how charcoal is made? Did you know that you can make it in your very own house? Let's see how.
But safety is first. Now, even though you may use this appliance every day in your home, it can still cause unsafe conditions. So please be careful, and just to be extra safe, I am going to use our safety equipment, and you probably should too.
So we will start by placing a piece of bread in the toaster, and you're going to want to crank it all the way up. And now we wait. What happens when toast is in the toaster for too long? That's right, it starts to turn black. This black is charcoal. Now, this isn't the same charcoal that you would use to grill your food, but nonetheless, it is charcoal.
So how does toast actually turn black? Well, to explain this, let's start with our caramel experiment. Do you remember when we used heat to break down sugar into carbon, and that made that brown, tasty caramel? It was very delicious. Did you eat it too? But today, with the toast, we're not starting with sugar, which is a simple carbohydrate or carb. Instead, we'll be starting with starch, which is a complex carbohydrate or complex carb. Now, we will still be using heat, but instead of using heat to break sugar down into carbon, we'll be using heat to break starch down into sugar, breaking down complex carbs into simple carbs. Now, the biggest difference here is that the sugar then reacts with amino acids within the bread, and it browns it. Now, this is technically charcoal, but when we did the caramel experiment, there were no amino acids within the sugar for the sugar to react with. But in the bread, there are amino acids, and the sugar reacts with it. Now, amino acids are just the building blocks for a protein. They make up a protein. But if you want more information on amino acids or carbohydrates or anything for that matter, just let me know and I'll do a video on it. But this is called the Maillard reaction, where amino acids react with sugar, and this gives browned foods its darker color and delicious flavor. Now, the different flavors depend on the different amino acids that are present. Now, like I said before, this isn't the same kind of charcoal that you would use on a grill. So please do not try to use it and do not eat it. Too much burnt foods can actually be really bad for you. So please don't try feeding it to the birds or any other animals. It's best to just throw it away because it can be bad for us and it can be bad for them. So would you say that this is a physical or a chemical change? Well, did it change into a completely different substance? Yes. It went from a carbohydrate to charcoal. Now, is it reversible? Can we make the charcoal go back into bread? No. So this is a chemical reaction. That's right. And now for the fun part. So the contest is that I need your guys' help. I could not come up with a way to relate this to God. The charcoal and the burnt toast and the carbohydrates with oxygen and heat, how do you come up with a metaphor for God? So if you can think of a way, let me know. Message me, let me know on Facebook or YouTube or whichever way possible, and I will pick the best one. And the winner will be able to explain their metaphor on my next video. So put your thinking caps on, and until next time,